What's going on, you guys? I'm Lawson, and today I want to talk to you about, I think, the five big mistakes that new YouTubers tend to make. And hopefully we can go over these and you can learn something and start growing your YouTube channel. All this stuff is just things that I have learned and gathered over the past 6 years of being a full-time YouTuber over on my main channel. So let's jump into it and see if we can help you grow your channel. Number one, upload consistently. I think there's basically two ways to grow on YouTube now, and it's either making insane, captivating masterpiece videos. I want you to think of like Mark Rober and Mr. Beast, and for people who watch gaming stuff like Dream, these videos that get insane, insanely high views because it's just preposterous things that are happening. Or you gotta feed the beast and you need to upload very, very consistently. And that is a much more reasonable thing to do. YouTube basically rewards creators for uploading more content. YouTube's whole goal is to keep people on their platform. So when creators are consistently putting out videos and people are consistently clicking on them and watching them, they want to send people to it, and they will feed your channel out to new audiences and help you grow a ton. If you are not uploading consistently, YouTube doesn't help you out as much. And I know that from firsthand. It is insane the number difference in views that I will experience if I am uploading 4 to 5 times a week consistently for a month or two versus uploading once or twice a week over the course of like 2 months. It is drastic how bad your views can be if you're not on top of it, which can be really hard, especially if you have a full-time job or something like that. I'm lucky that I do YouTube as a full-time job, but sometimes I would get burnt out and I would let my video uploads kind of slack, and I would get punished for it. If you want to grow, you just need to upload a lot and feed the beast, and YouTube will reward you for it. Number two, clickbaiting is what we'll call it, but I'm talking about making good titles and thumbnails. That's something that I didn't really know until I had like 10,000 subscribers, and it took me a long time to figure out. It is imperative. I wish it wasn't. I wish that titles and thumbnails didn't matter and the video content spoke for itself, but unfortunately, that's just not the way it is on YouTube. You need to make really, really captivating titles and thumbnails. Now, you don't ever want to actually clickbait people, meaning deceive them. In my own personal industry, making outdoors videos, fishing videos, I have known a lot of channels who have grown really fast by making extreme clickbait videos where they're basically deceiving their audience. And they've gotten, you know, millions of views on these videos and they've grown, but my God, is the fall hard. Eventually you run out of crazy ideas. People figure out that, oh, you're just a liar and the stuff that you upload is just nonsense. And they stop coming back and they stop watching and you've lost viewers' trust. I know channels who have 2 times, 3 times more subscribers than I do and will get 1/10 the views on their videos because they've lost their viewers' trust. You don't wanna do that. Titles and thumbnails need to ask a question. You want someone to look at it and be captivated when they see it and they go, okay, well, I have to see what happens next or what actually happens in this video. I like to avoid things that tell you directly what happened. So for example, for me, I know this is not gonna be super relatable for everyone. I make fishing videos. I never put the fish that I'm catching in the title or the thumbnail of the video, because you are answering the question for the person when they see that. Instead, you just say big fish, a monster fish, a huge fish, because a fish could be anything. And also on top of that, I think making things kind of general can be really helpful because you're not excluding people. If I wrote down snook, which is a type of fish, a lot of people wouldn't understand what that even is and probably wouldn't click on the thumbnail. But if you wrote like catching a huge fish, people would be like, well, I know what a fish is at least. I want to see a big fish. So you leave it out of titles and you don't put it in the thumbnail because then you're showing them what they're coming for. Now, this can definitely vary on certain things because some YouTube videos that are like product reviews, yes, you want to put the product in it, but you're trying to get clicks based off of the SEO, the search engine optimization of someone looking for that exact product. When you're making more like live action content, you need to make it a question. You need to make it titillating and make people want to click on your video and see what's happening. Number three, this almost shouldn't be said, but unfortunately it kind of does. Just make good videos. Like, I know that's so ridiculous. Have decent audio. Have the footage not be shaky and look like crap. work on things. And those are all things that you don't have to have insane equipment to do. It just takes a little bit of extra thought and effort to make sure your camera's set up well. Make sure you're not filming something directly in the wind so your audio sounds horrible. Maybe it's turning off your ceiling fan when you're trying to record audio. Just make your video quality good. YouTube rewards viewer duration. Meaning, if you can hold people on your video for a long time, then that makes them want to push that video out more to new viewers. So if your video sucks, it's not going to hold people's retention. That's just the truth of the matter. So you don't have to make giant masterpieces, but put some effort into it. Don't just half-ass things. That's really it. And kind of piggybacking on that idea, number four, creativity and entertainment will always beat out equipment. That's just the truth. It's an easy excuse to make, oh, well, I'll start making videos when I have this piece of equipment. Oh, well, once I have this, I can do that. And there are certain things where, you know, maybe you can't start filming until you have a camera. But guess what? You have a phone, you have a camera. Congratulations, you can now make YouTube videos. There are tons and tons of creators who've gotten to 100,000, 200,000, 500,000 followers using their phone camera. This thing shoots in 4K. And this is like a 3-year-old iPhone. The new ones are ridiculous. There's not really an excuse anymore for equipment. And I actually find that a lack of equipment brings creativity and diversity into your videos. It can make some of the best stuff. A good example for me is I have a fishing channel and I used to fish out of a boat all the time. I ended up needing to sell my boat. And during the time that I'm trying to find a new boat, I went from filming in a boat, what you associate making fishing videos out of kinda, to riding a bicycle around to fish, and it ended up being some of my favorite content that I've ever created, and the people who watch my channel end up loving it. You're talking about two hugely drastic different equipment pieces, a bicycle versus a boat, and what you're capable of doing with that, but if you can be creative and you can be entertaining, people will watch it. So don't let improper equipment keep you from making videos. It's just a bad excuse, to be honest. And number five, this is something that I'm still working on growing, and I think every YouTuber can work on, but it's especially imperative when you are a new YouTuber, is understanding your audience and following growth trends. Now, what do I mean by that? If you have uploaded 10 videos and one of them has twice the views of all your other uploads, there's obviously a reason for that. You need to dissect what it is. Maybe it's the title, maybe it's the thumbnail, maybe it's the activity that you were doing, maybe it's the way it was filmed. Try to figure that out, and you want to extract that information and put it into new videos. I don't want you to go and make the exact same video 10 times over. People do that and it ends up beating it into the ground. You need to take the concept that was working, put a twist on it, and replicate it. It means a few things. YouTube likes your video. Your audience is enjoying that style of video and you're doing something right. Don't ignore those. Most of the time, it's not just absolute randomness. Sometimes that does happen with YouTube, where I've had videos on my main channel get picked up by the algorithm and a video just randomly got 900,000 views that probably, to be honest, shouldn't have. That can happen, but it's so, so rare. You need to focus on the consistent things, where if you have a bunch of videos that all 500 views and one of them has 2,000, try to make some videos like the one with 2,000. It can be really detrimental if you ignore those things early on, because you're basically ignoring your audience's demand and you're ignoring pure evidence of what was working. So try to latch onto that and really study it. So hopefully those five tips helped you out and will help you grow your YouTube channel. This all actually came to life in my Twitch stream that I do every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday, where a lot of people will come in and ask me questions on how to grow their YouTube channel. And there was a guy actually in chat named Ethan who came in and was asking a bunch of questions, and I told him basically these things. And it's actually why I wanted to make this video and why I wrote these things down. And he came back a week later and he said he went back into some of his old videos, made new titles, made new thumbnails, and already saw growth and already saw subscriber gain in a single week just by making some small tweaks and changes. So this stuff works. It's not just blowing smoke out of my ass, you know? So implement these things and hopefully you will see some growth. Hopefully you guys appreciated and enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you like, subscribe, whatever, but leave some comments down below and give me some questions of future videos or future topics you'd like me to cover talking about YouTube or Twitch or camera gear, editing, anything like that. I want to know. I want to hear it. I appreciate you guys. Hopefully this stuff helps you out. Until next time, peace.